Panskwame ay nakaredy ng maglaro para sa ating Gilas Pilipinas at excited na rin itong makaharap si Ricardo Ratcliffe ng South Korea at Lester Prosper ng Indonesia. At tunghayan po natin ang kanyang interview at highlights. Pero bago po ang lahat, at kung bago ka lang sa akin channel ay pasubscribe naman mga idol at i-hit na rin ang notification bell para lagi tayong updated. Maraming salamat.
Angelo Kwame is counting down the days before he officially becomes a naturalized Filipino citizen. Although he knows that there is a lot of pressure in occupying that one spot, Ange is ready to give it his best.
Back in March 15, the Senate approved the naturalization of Kwame as they merged their bill with a version from the House of Representatives. It's now only awaiting the signature of President Rodrigo Duterte, but if the President does not act on the proposal, it will automatically lapse into law 30 days after receipt.
At the same time, I'm sure very excited. Mostly excited because, you know, it's been a thought since probably a year now. So I prepare myself for it, like, individually and mentally.
If there is a silver lining with the two cancellations in the final window of the FIBA Asia Cup qualifiers, it is that there's a strong chance that Kwame will be able to suit up for the first time wearing a Gilas jersey. Now that the IATF has officially allowed the Clark bubble, Kwame knows his national team debut could be very close.
I was really excited about it because I've been thinking about, like, when we first exit from the bubble since the, you know, COVID and everything. So being at home, I was, you know, just doing physical preparation since we couldn't go outside shooting and get like any kind of practices. So I was really excited to, you know, be entering the next bubble because we know this previous bubble is gonna be the most important, especially against those games coming forward.
If he gets to play in Clark, Kwame will be tested early as he will possibly go up against two naturalized players who are both former PBA imports in Ricardo Ratcliffe of South Korea and Lester Prosper of Indonesia.
I've been scouted them since they play against Ratcliffe for the Jones Cup, if you remember. And for Prosper, I'm not really sure what type of player he's about. I see a couple of his game in the PBA, so I mean I scout them, like, see their weakness and their strength, and it gets me really excited to go against these guys.
Aside from playing a system that he's already comfortable with, the good thing for Kwame in this bubble is that he gets additional training from a 17-year NBA veteran in coach Alton Lester.
Oh, it's impressive for me because he's the kind of coach who always pushes me to keep working out. So having him around is I'm trying to learn as much as I can from him, and he teach me a lot of things like move and how to play outside and inside the paint, and it's really helpful since, you know, that my Ateneo process until now. So I keep learning from him every single day.
Kwame's case is unique, because even though he had great tools and abilities, his development as a basketball player took a big leap here in the country with Ateneo. So he will be playing not just as a naturalized Filipino citizen, but as a real product of Philippine basketball.
I had a couple of days from my regular stay here, meaning my energy on the court and everything, but learning the basketball system is under Ateneo, so I've been learning like most of my basketball career here in the Philippines, and it's something that, like, you know, really helped me as a player individually. So yeah, you can say I am a Filipino product basketball.